to approve the minutes?
Robbie's looking, I'm second.
Okay, Robbie made a motion, Darwin second, all four say aye.
Aye.
Motion passes. Financial report?
Okay, in operating, we have $1,213,224.54. Payroll account has $109,894.90 with a payroll tomorrow. The CD is still $2,153,763.33.
Do I hear a motion to accept the financial report?
I'll make that motion.
Darwin? Robbie second, all four say aye.
Aye.
Motion passes. Supplemental pay.
Okay, so, we go from board meeting to board meeting.
Right.
So we did have a COVID unit during that time, and so it's up a little bit, it was $6,440. So I would say at least half of that probably is for the COVID unit and staff who work that.
Right.
And then the other is for the ones who have worked extra shift, or the ones who have been out with COVID and things like that.
Right.
We would ask to extend that again, of course, right now, we're not paying out any COVID unit pay, but, you know, that could change tomorrow.
Right.
Depending on if we have any positives or not, so.
Right.
We would ask to extend that at least another month.
You need that to make a motion?
Yes.
I'll make that motion.
Robbie made a motion to extend the supplemental pay.
I'll second.
Darwin second. Robbie?
Yes.
Yes.
Darwin?
Yes.
Donna, yes. Motion passes. Money, you have to do that, I'm sorry. Administrator's report.
We are still testing our staff twice a week, all staff.
Is that due to the percentage?
It is, the positivity rate in the county.
Right.
Which is still at a high level, but it is coming down slowly.
Right.
Which is good news.
So what percentage of the staff has been vaccinated?
We're about 60% vaccinated.
Which is good.
We started out about 40%.
Right.
Yeah.
Jim and Sam, we had 81 cases in the county today, morning, and so it is coming down, we went from 400 to 81 in the last month and a half.
But we test our staff, so then if any of those are positive, then we have to do outbreak testing for the residents to see if any of those are positive. And they cut it back to where, like, if that staff member only worked on a certain area, then those are the ones we have to test.
Test. Most all of the patients, though, are vaccinated, right?
We're 90% vaccinated.
Right.
For residents, yes.
Right.
And our pharmacy that we contract with is coming in and doing any new admissions that want to be vaccinated.
Right.
Yeah, so we're keeping that going. So our census is 68 today. We're set to admit one tomorrow and then two on Monday. So that's just that's a balance game with our staffing and how many we can take. So maybe by Monday we'll be in the 70s.
Right.
That'll be the first time in a long time since COVID started.
Yeah, well, we got up in there and then got back down. It's a balance right now. Staffing and things like that, but we're trying to get another class together, hopefully.
Right.
So our home delivered meal program, I want to talk about that just a few minutes. I know I've been telling y'all that, you know, they're expecting more of the caregivers in the home, which they should.
Yeah.
So they've been.
Like when they did the choices program,
yes,
and all that stuff,
yes,
to cook for them.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
So it's been.
So eventually this will phase itself out.
I feel like it is. I really feel like it is. I think we've run our course because they're expecting the caregivers in the home to do it. So
right.
We've not been getting any new ones. And the regulation part of it has really got difficult. I mean, it takes a lot of, you just don't believe to take a meal to somebody's home that it would be that regulated, but it is. because that's who's paying for it. And of course, there's increased food costs, there's increased gas costs, you know. And then labor is another issue, which we have a faithful driver, Danny, who's been very faithful. But I do look for this program to phase out.
Well, if this program phases out, what happens to Danny?
He'll work in our dietary department.
Okay.
So how far out in the county do you have?
We go all over the county right now. We sure do. Oh, go ahead.
I was just saying, it's a good program, I'm looking.
It is a great program. At one time, I think we had like, what, 50, 70?
We were up in the 70s.
Yeah, we had three drivers out on the road.
Right. Well, as long as part of this 25 need them, will you continue to serve them?
Well, as long as it can be financially sustainable, you know, and that's, they're not going up on what they're paying us to do it.
Right.
Plus the regulation part, you know, like they, one of the FCOs came to us and said, you have to be USDA inspected. And we're like, we've been doing this 12 years, 13 years, we've never been US. I mean, we have a state inspection, you know, they come in and give us those approvals. And finally, they backed off on that, but you know, it just takes time to know it. Because they get new hires, and you have to explain this stuff, and they want this, and they want that, and they want us to do more background checks on the people who
go
in the kitchen and go
to
the home, and it's just, it's a lot.
Right.
It's just a lot. I mean, we've been glad to do it, we've been happy to do it, but we will try to serve these as best we can, as long as we can, and when we can't, we'll make sure they have somebody who
Yeah, I just don't want anybody to be hungry.
Yeah, and there's different providers, you know, I know they do it at the senior center, you know, that might be an option if it gets down to just a couple where it's not feasible for us to do it anymore, but. So yeah, we'll help them, we'll help them. We did have a COVID-19 infection control survey conducted by the Department of Health on September the 28th, so if a facility has an outbreak, staff or residents, they're gonna come in and check and make sure you're doing what you're supposed to be doing. And so they said we were, and no deficiencies were cited, and so that's, we were happy over that. Not happy they come, but happy that there were no deficiencies.
No deficiencies, yes.
Yes. So that's all I've got.
Robbie, do you have anything?
No.
Darwin?
No.
I don't either. Do I hear entertainment to adjourn?
I'll make a motion.
I'll second. The next meeting is?
Yeah, next meeting, the 17th, that'll be on Wednesday.
November the 17th.
Because we got meetings in between there, is that okay?
At 5:00, right?
Right, and
We'll have you here.
The next week is Thanksgiving, so that'd be hard to do.
We might as well keep having it here.
That's what I was gonna say, as far as I'm concerned, I think we might just have it here and be done with it.
Long as it ain't too hard on you all, is it?
Oh, no, this is hard, this is fine.
Okay. All right, we do.
Okay, Darwin made a motion to adjourn, and Robbie seconded. All four say aye.
Aye.
Aye, any opposed? Motion passes.
Well, you guys have a good one and receive for Thanksgiving.
Yeah, y'all too.
Don't eat anything, I'll have it.
Don't get tricked.
Oh, yeah, Alan's coming up. They gonna have that trunk or treat, I think, so.
Oh, yeah, we're doing.